we face a dilemma, that at the moment we are meeting a new energy demand chiefly by turning to fossil fuels. And we know that even if we were to continue on that trajectory, we would need to invest very heavily in energy infrastructure broadly. And by the calculations we've done, that amounts to around in the region of $45 trillion over the next 15 years, so incredible amounts. But this also creates an opportunity, of course, because we will have to invest heavily. And this then also creates a window of opportunity to steer those investments towards other new sources that also then have other advantages, including reducing greenhouse gas emissions. The past growth in coal is not necessarily one that we think is going to serve the world well, countries well, in decades to come. It's time for a re-evaluation, and the way we like to put it is that it used to be a presumption that coal was the default model, and we need to turn that around, actually. The burden of proof now, given the damage that coal does, the burden of proof really needs to be on the new coal projects to show that this is the best or the only way to meet the energy need, and otherwise to turn to alternatives that are increasingly available. Renewable energy is already getting to the point where, if you take into account the impacts on air pollution, on energy security and diversification and other objectives that already are there, it can become a major contributor to meeting future energy needs. And this is really quite unexpected. I don't think that many would have thought that we were there 10 years ago, whereas now even fairly conservative projections see them as contributing up to half of the new electricity in the world over the next 15 years. And what we find, looking at the evidence that now is available, is that it could be even more. A lot of adaptation will be needed, the way we run electricity systems, the way we finance energy. And we, in the report, we describe various aspects of this. But it's also something that different countries will have to approach differently. Fast-growing countries will face a different situation from ones that have slow growth, such as Europe. And of course, in many developing countries, there's a big question whether renewable energy can contribute also to energy access in a new way. Indications are that it can, but we are still working out the models for doing that.